Hello guys, good morning. Today I'm going to speaking about the reflexive pronouns, okay? The idea is continue in this topic and you learn new vocabulary, practice according to the examples, and really be careful, and that's it. What is the goal? The goal is identify a reflexive pronoun in a sentence or grammar context. Let's remember, what are the reflexive pronouns? We use reflexive pronouns when we want to refer to the same pronoun twice in one sentence. They usually end with self in single or selves in plural. And also, a reflexive pronoun is used to show that the action of the verb affects the person who performed the action. Recordemos que los pronombres reflexivos se usan para una acción que afecta directamente a un verbo o que hacemos mención hacia una persona, la acción que hace una persona, ¿ok? So, remember what is the correct use in reflexive pronouns. You have subject pronouns, I, you, he, she, it, we, you in plural, and they. And what is a reflexive pronoun in this subject pronouns? You say, I, in reflexive, is myself. You, in reflexive, yourself. He, in reflexive, himself. She, in reflexive, herself. It, in reflexive, itself. We, in reflexive, is ourselves. And you, in plural, in reflexive, is yourselves. And they, reflexive, is themselves. Okay? So, guys, that's me. I, myself, you, yourself, he, himself, she, herself, it, itself, we, ourselves, you, yourselves, and they, themselves. ¿Okay? Recordemos que cada uno de estos pronombres reflexivos traducen mí mismo, tú misma, el mismo, ella mismo, esto mismo, nosotros mismos. Nosotros mismos, o ustedes mismos, y ellos mismos. ¿Okay? Eso es lo que traduce en sí cada una de estas pronombres reflexivos. ¿Okay? Simplemente estamos recordándolo. So, look at this example, another example, using reflexive pronouns. Be careful, don't cut yourself with that knife. Ten cuidado, no te cortes tú mismo con el cuchillo. Second one. Our cat washes itself after every meal. Nuestros gatos se lavan por sí mismos después de tomar cada alimento. Number three. We bake the cake by ourselves. Nosotros cocinamos o horneamos el pastel por nosotros mismos. Number four. Come in, everybody, and find yourself a seat. Vamos a encontrar por nosotros mismos la silla. Okay? Next. The children cleaning their room all by themselves. Los niños limpian su habitación por cuenta de ellos mismos. Okay? Next, bears like to roof themselves against a tree. Los osos se rascan como contra el árbol por ellos mismos. Okay? Next, the bird washes itself by splashing in a puddle. And the last one, the players train every day to take themselves it. Okay. Recordemos que todos los pronombres reflexivos son los que están subrayados allí. Okay? Yourself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, themselves. And that's it. Another example. I was in a hurry, so I washed the car myself. Tuve prisa y yo preferí o lavé el carro por mí mismo. Okay? Next, you are going to have to drive yourself to school today. Hoy mismo tú vas a conducir, por ti mismo vas a conducir para ir a la escuela, al colegio. Okay? Next, Esteban wanted to impress her, so he baked a cake himself. Esteban quiere impresionarla a ella. Él quiere cocinar hornear o cocinar un pastel por él mismo, ¿cierto? Porque va a impresionar a la chica. Okay. Next example. Daniela does chores herself because nobody helped it. And the last one. We don't have to go out. We can fix dinner ourselves. Nosotros no vamos a salir. No vamos a salir. Vamos a preparar nuestros alimentos en casa por nosotros mismos. ¿Ok? Recordemos cada uno de estos pronombres reflexivos. ¿Ok? Porque son muy usados en el inglés. Si ustedes observan en una canción o en una película, todo lo que tenga que ver con la parte del speaking, son muy usados estos personal pronouns. Y en su caso, los pronombres reflexivos. And finally, this is activity for today. Remember, you have to enter the Moodle and the English and make into the workshop according to this topic, okay? Reflexive pronouns in Google Forms. That's it for today. Thank you so much. Goodbye. God bless you.